press release. Steve Brown's first ever solo release, Where Do We Run? New single now available on all digital music platforms. Ringwood, New Jersey, August 13, 2021. Veteran guitarist and singer-songwriter, Steve Brown, of Trixter, Tokyo Motor Fist, Def Leppard, Dennis DeYoung, has just dropped his inaugural solo single and accompanying music video, to be released the 19th of August, 2021, for the song Where Do We Run? Not only does he shine with his lead vocal and melodic guitar playing, he also produced, engineered and mixed the track himself. Brown draws fans in for an intimate peek at his prolific songwriting style, while showcasing his versatility on the other side of the recording booth. Where Do We Run features a classic rock vibe reminiscent of Led Zeppelin and Jimi Hendrix, while invoking Pink Floyd-esque riffs. The song shows some of my biggest influences from stellar guitar player/vocalists like Richie Sambora, of Bon Jovi, Steve Lukather, of TOTO, Peter Frampton, John Sykes, formerly of WHITESNAKE, Thin Lizzy, and the late, great Gary Moore, says Brown. The idea for Where Do We Run was first born in 1994, when Brown built his home studio, Mojo Vegas 6160. I was writing a few songs to pitch to movies and Where Do We Run seemed like the perfect song for a dark love story. I had my hands in a lot of projects back then and it just got put on the back burner. I rediscovered the song in 2020, while I was completing the second album, Lions for Tokyo Motor Fist. Upon hearing it again, I remembered how much I loved this song. With today's political and emotional climate, I felt it is more relevant than ever and the world needed to hear it. Where Do We Run strikes a chord with the challenging times we are all living in. It runs through the gamut of emotions. It is a tale of yearning, agony, reflection, love, loss, but most importantly, hope. For my first official solo release ever, I wanted to show a different side of my sound both vocally and musically, and not the obvious arena rock production that I'm known for, said Brown. Where Do We Run is more of a classic rock production, laced with natural and authentic sounds. I brought my dear friends, Joey Cassato on drums, ZO2, Trans-Siberian Orchestra, Eric Ragno on keys, Graham Bonnet and the Babies, Chris Lester on bass, Sonny Erna's Avalon and Zen Boy, to completely take this track into the stratosphere. The song may be inspired by the classic rock sound of yesteryear, but its captivating lyrical content, infused with rich, layered melodies and ethereal tones, delivers it to our present-day doorstep, gift-wrapped and tied with a big, fat alluring bow. Like a sign of the times, Where Do We Run is haunting, yet beautiful, with a dose of aspiration we all could use. Where Do We Run was written, produced, engineered and mixed by Steve Brown. Mastered by Stephen Diakachis at Sound Spa Productions, New Jersey. The homegrown video was shot in the scenic mountains of Ringwood, New Jersey by Jason Findlay of Jason Adam Photography. Directed by Steve Brown and Jason Findlay. My sincere gratitude to Shireen Eve for PR support. Music video for Where Do We Run will be released on Friday, August 19, 2021. Hear and buy Steve's new single at https://stevebrown.hernow.com. Steve Brown was born and raised in New Jersey, destined to live a life submersed in music. The mostly self-taught artist picked up his first guitar at 8 years old and never looked back. Steve began his lifelong love affair with live performing at the ripe old age of 12, when he became a regular on the voltaic New Jersey rock scene of the 80s. At 12 years old, he began writing music, lyrics and founded his first band, Trixter. It wasn't long before Steve led the mighty Trixter to a record deal with MCA Records, sold out arena tours and living every aspect of the rock and roll dream. In his over 35-year career, Steve has sold over 3 million records worldwide. Billboard Top 40 Album. RIA Certified Gold Album. Peaked at number 28. Written 3 Billboard Top 100 singles, starred in 3 number 1 MTV videos, and shared the stage with the likes of Kiss, Van Halen, Journey, Alice Cooper, Deep Purple, Scorpions, David Lee Roth, Poison, Cheap Trick, Styx, Boston, Duran Duran, Night Ranger, Rick Springfield and Tesla. As not only a master guitarist, but as an accomplished songwriter, singer, engineer and producer working with Mike Shipley, who worked with Def Leppard, Shania Twain, James Jimbo Barton, who worked with Rush, Aerosmith, Kiss, and Metallica, Skid Mills, who worked with ZZ Top and Three Doors Down, Ryan Maloof, who worked with Queen and Pearl Jam, Bill Ray, who worked with Loverboy and Diana Ross, and Jack Ponti, who worked with Bon Jovi and Alice Cooper. Steve has become one of the music industry's most sought-after and entrusted talents. From personal endorsements by Eddie Van Halen to churning out original music for some of television's most popular hits, to regularly hitting the stage with an ever-growing list of rock and roll greats, Steve Brown is in constant demand. Most recently, Steve has played with Dennis DeYoung, formerly of Styx, Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp, Jolyn Turner, formerly of Rainbow, Deep Purple and Yngwie Malmsteen, and on Broadway in the hit musical Rock of Ages. In 2013, Steve was invited to be the vicarial guitarist for the legendary Def Leppard, which led to him joining the band at the historic Wembley Stadium along with many other arena and stadium shows throughout North America. In May of 2018 he pulled off a job never done before when was called in with 24 hours notice to aid Phil Collins for three shows, thus giving him the distinct honor of covering duties for both Def Leppard guitarists. A stunt he would later repeat in early 2019 for Dennis DeYoung. This has never been done before in the illustrious world of rock. A true testament to Brown's talent, loyalty and love for his craft. Steve currently fulfills his gigs with Trixter, Dennis DeYoung, Wizards of Winter, Danger Danger, Eric Martin, Mr. Big, Comedian Jim Brewer, Rubik's Cube, Broadway's Rock of Ages Band, Tokyo Motor Fist and Def Leppard, while continuing to cultivate his ever-expanding expertise, experience and true passion for all that is music. During 2020 to 2021, Steve had six albums and three singles digitally released: Tokyo Motor Fist Lions, Trixter New Audio Machine, Trixter Human Era, Stereo Fallout The Other Side, 40-foot Ringo Funny Thing, the Kiss cover tune A Million to One, Rockin' Christmas Time, single, and his latest track Where Do We Run. More information can be found at Steve's website www.stevebrownrocks.com. Copyright and published, 2021 Brownstone Music Incorporated. Press release contact, Cherie Neve at Cherie and Eve.